So David and Lucas are starving and want to share a pizza. It's uncut, and Lucas tells David, "We want 4 slices each. Make 4 cuts through the center, vertical, horizontal, and at the 2 45-degree angles. While you're doing that, I'll go get the pop or soda or Coke." That last phrase was used because depending on where you live or visit, people call hypersugar fizzy water different things. Anyway, you expected the pizza slices to look like this, but David made a fatal blunder. He seriously misidentified the center, so after the cuts, there are troll and hobbit-sized slices. But since David and Lucas are neither hobbits nor trolls, they want to split the pizza evenly. How is this possible? There's an easy solution called the pizza theorem. If each person takes alternating slices, they each end up with exactly half of the pizza. It doesn't matter where the center point for cutting is specified. This strategy gives each person the same amount. One can use calculus to prove the pizza theorem, but for an easier way, look at this picture. The pizza has been further divided into many regions, each containing a number. Each number appears in 2 congruent regions, once in violet and once in orange. This implies that the orange area equals the violet area, so each person gets the same amount of pizza. This proof by picture works no matter where the center is placed. The pizza theorem strategy also gives each person exactly the same amount of edge crust. This may be good or bad depending on whether you don't like the edge or you gorge on stuffed crust. This claim, should we call it the crust theorem, follows from 2 applications of the pizza theorem. The areas on the slices of the outer pizza match, but so do the areas of the inner pizza, that is, the part without crust. The difference of the inner and the outer produce equal amounts of crust for each person. The crust theorem implies that the perimeter of the circle is divided into 2 sets of equal length. The pizza theorem does not work with only 4 slices. The yellow area is clearly larger than the red area. However, the pizza theorem does work for more than 8 slices of pizza. If there are 12, 16, 20, or any greater multiple of 4 slices, and the angles of each slice are the same, taking alternating slices still splits the pizza into 2 equal amounts. So, the world may not be fair, but you don't need to draw daggers over who gets more pizza.